Hi, aspiring writers, writing coach Stefanie Newell, and this is the Life of a Writer channel. This week's video is all about writing tools for authors. Learn what you need to start writing your book. If you want to write a book that helps you to connect with readers and sell more books, make sure to subscribe as I post new videos every Tuesday. Whether you want to write a memoir or a romance novel, every author will need tools and software to get started. In this video, I will outline the best tools for writers. Category number one is electronics. Every writer needs a reliable electronic that can handle the storage a book requires. When choosing one, whether it's a phone, computer, or tablet, you also need to consider your budget, storage, ease of use, and whether your writing software will be compatible. For example, if you're considering your phone to write a book, will you be able to comfortably write 40,000 to 80,000 words on it? Make sure you're choosing a device that will help you to get results. Category number two is writing software. Writing software is the most important tool for writers. Choose software based on how tech savvy you are, as software that has too many bells and whistles may be overwhelming to you. Remember, you're trying to start your book, so choose software that will be easiest to learn. As you gain more experience using the software, you can then branch off into software with more features. When it comes to writing software, I highly recommend Microsoft Word, Google Docs, Final Draft, and iBooks Author, depending on needs and preferences. They all have great features and are fairly easy to learn, and some are even free. If you're looking for more information on any of the writing tools discussed, I do have a playlist linked in the description box. Category number three is apps. Some of the best apps aren't necessarily for writers. Depending on the genre you write, there is an array of great writing apps to choose from. In previous videos, I've shared numerous writing apps for writers, but in this video, I want to share a not so obvious one, and that app is YouTube. YouTube is a great writing tool as it allows you to research your book. By watching videos like mine, you can learn how to write a book, and you can grow, nurture, and market to your target audience right here on YouTube. It's obviously a platform you're comfortable with, as video is a great way to consume content. When I began my writing journey on YouTube, I had no idea that it would grow to over 16,000 subscribers and 887,000 views. We often hear people joke that they've attended YouTube University, but it's true. YouTube, if used correctly, can help you to learn not only how to write your book, but also to identify and market to your target audience. If you're interested in a video where I share how to grow on YouTube as a writer, let me know in the comments. Category number four is books. Books on writing are valuable resources because they provide the steps for you to start. Choose books that make the process simple, as learning a new skill is often learned best when you're not feeling overwhelmed. For example, in my ebook, How to Start Your Book, I provide the simplest strategy to help you start writing the first words, paragraph, and chapter for your book. As a writer of well over 15 years, I still read books on writing, and I actively seek out tips and strategies to help me grow. When choosing books, consider an array of authors, as we all have unique experiences and they all can be of value to you as a first-time writer. And remember, books are one of those resources that you will continually use. As a writer, you should read books that deal with writing, publishing, marketing, social media, and building an author brand, to name a few. Category number five is social media. Even though you're starting your book, you should begin your marketing at the same time. And I get it, marketing sounds overwhelming, and especially for first-time writers. But at this point in the process, it's really just the beginning stages of identifying your target audience. It doesn't have to be a big task, but you need to start. You need to begin finding the people who'll be interested in your book while you're writing your book. And then once your book is published, you'll have an audience to market to. Choose a social media platform where your target audience is. You should feel comfortable with the platform, and you should be able to be consistent. Once you determine your platform, identify the people on the platform that will gain the most value from your book. Share your writing journey through your social media posts and engage with the audience you attract. In the past, I've used Facebook, Twitter, and Pinterest, but now I primarily use Instagram and YouTube to grow my target audience. Choose the platform that makes the most sense for you and your book. As always, all of my social media links will be in the description box below. If you're looking to hire me as your writing coach, you'll find that information there as well. And I look forward to talking with you in my next video.